fingers on lips. In that special place that she would eclipse, she'd read me poems, tell me tales, and sing me songs, and like a fish to its source, I was drawn in. I loved the way she'd hold the book, you know, so as you could see the pictures, and the way she'd slowly move it from side to side so that even the naughty kids at the back could see. She told me I was allowed to dream. She got us to act out plays. I remember doing Finnegan's Wake. She told me about Shakespeare, George Shaw, Joyce, Keats and Yeats, and I was eight. But in that room, her voice was sweet music, echoing prayers and hymns and stories and songs. She was a living angel, but you'd know if you'd done wrong. She took us on school trips to castles with moats. We'd cross oceans on boats and we would float without ever actually leaving the room. I love the way she made a simple act of reading the class register sound like the most beautifully sung tune, simply by the way she would validate kids' names by saying, Catherine, Stephen, Mary, James. And sometimes she'd get us to close our eyes and she'd say, imagine worlds beyond these skies. And she told me once, Michael, it's all right to cry. And her eyes, well, her eyes were seaside blue sunshine, but in that rainy 1970s, black and white moss side where my messed up little brain would disappear the very second that woman walked into the room. She made my insignificant life signify. And she told me that the more I'd read, the more I'd see, and the more I'd see, the more I'd know, and the more I'd know, the more I'd grow, the more I am. And I'd give the world and all its riches just to hold that woman's hand one more time and say thanks. Oh, miss. Thank you. Thanks.